What's up you guys, it's Joelle and welcome back to another video. Oh, you know what I can do? I can grab a Dartmouth hat. Oh my goodness. Okay, there. Does this look more appropriate now for today's video? Today's video is going to be on the things that I love and hate about Dartmouth. I know Ivy Day is coming up, so I just wanted to make a little video focusing a little bit on like the pros and cons. Just because I know I focus a lot on the pros. I have so many videos showing how fun and wonderful and awesome Dartmouth is, but I also want to talk about things that aren't always so good, just because it'd be really helpful. Like, I knew a lot of this stuff coming into Dartmouth. I applied ED as a senior in high school, got in, I'm currently a senior. And I had a sister who was there before me, so I knew a lot of stuff about Dartmouth. I knew the good and the bad, and I was able to make a very informed decision. So for those of you guys who just got into Dartmouth, congrats, that's amazing. And I hope that this video can be a little more informative in helping you make a decision on where to spend the next 4 years of your life. I wanna preface this by saying that a lot of things that I dislike about Dartmouth, I think are things that very much can be improved and, you know, should be improved. I would also say that a lot of things that I don't like about Dartmouth are not Dartmouth specific. So a lot of them are issues that I think exist at a lot of schools. So I want you to keep that in mind when I'm saying these things. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, please like comment down below because I'm happy to keep talking about Dartmouth. I wanna get other Dartmouth students in on this, but for now, I'm home on spring break by myself and I don't have anyone else I can shoot this video with. So I'm just doing it alone to get the ball rolling. But anyways, we're gonna start with the things that I dislike slash wish were improved at Dartmouth. Yay. Yeah, number one, Dartmouth is really hard to get to. You have to take a 3-hour coach from Boston, it's the closest city, and it's really just out of the way. And because of that, our Wi-Fi isn't very good and the cell reception is not great. The next thing is that I would love to see more tenured professors of color, and I don't really feel like the college takes into account a lot of like student opinions in terms of offering tenured positions at the school. They look at a lot of things like, you know, credentials and like publications and that sorts of things, which makes total sense. But there were, in my time at Dartmouth in the 4 years, there have been two professors that I like fervently wanted tenured, and a lot of other students did. We petitioned, we wrote letters, and Dartmouth just did not take that into account, and I was really upset because they are directly denying the students who would receive, like would benefit from these professors, and I'm just like, what? I've never heard of a school that's good at this. Dealing with sexual assault, like giving students resources, making students feel heard, making students feel like the school is doing something about it, especially when the perpetrator is a repeat offender or has like money in the game or something. Gets a little murky. I know it's hard because there actually have been allegations that were false, and that's really scary and discredits a lot of girls who have had like legitimate offenses against them, but I don't know. I would like to see colleges in the States, in the world as a whole, dealing with this issue better. And I wish I could offer a solution, which is why I'm like, I acknowledge that this is something that really needs to be worked on because like I don't have a perfect solution for it, but definitely needs to be dealt with. Similarly to that, like racism at Dartmouth, not great. In general, you'll meet fantastic people who are not racist, but there are some cases of just people like saying and writing like the most abominable things. I remember like my freshman fall, there was a lot of hate going on towards the Native American students on campus. If you know anything about the history of Dartmouth, it was founded by the white people to educate Native Americans. And while that's like a weird thing, I like that they offer a lot of scholarships to Native American students, and there's a lot of community for Native American students on campus. But the rest of the campus needs to get on board. If there is anyone being hateful towards a certain minority group of students on campus, and that's literally part of your college's mission, is to like provide resources for those students, then that's like a huge problem. The next thing is the taught helplessness when it comes to dealing with issues. Students who want to make administrative issues or help in that regard tend to get really burnt out because they're not received well by the administration, or they're just not supported well by the school. Sorry, the lighting is gonna change so much in this video. But because of that, like students are kind of taught that they can't make that much difference. There are cases where students are able to make huge differences in administrative issues and how things are dealt with on campus, and I just don't think those stories are shared as much. It's not as much of a prevalent feeling. So a lot of students feel like, oh, like the administration doesn't care. Which, and I don't think that's true. I think the administration does wanna help out, but I don't think they even know how to help out sometimes. And it's also something that I know is really prevalent at a lot of schools, especially Ivies. There's a lot of hoops to jump through and you really need to know how to find the right people if you want to make a change. Next thing is really just petty. It's just me. It's really cold, long winters. There's not super diverse food in terms of like the selection off campus. On campus, it's like decent for a school. It's actually pretty good for a college. Sorry, camera died. We back. I know I shouldn't complain about food. That's like not a huge deal. The next thing is that there's a huge discrepancy of the quality of dorms on campus. Just some are really old and some are super new and beautiful. And with the new call to lead, which is like Dartmouth's new like fundraising initiative slash like their plan of how they are going to allocate their budget, there's a lot of money going to like the housing system, but I don't think they really have plans to revamp old dorms. They might build some new ones, but they are not gonna fix the ones that are really jank and like were meant to be temporary. Just in general, like how Dartmouth distributes budget is not always great, or does not always seem to like address students' more immediate needs, even if it like is well intentioned. So the next thing I dislike is that there's a really heavy emphasis on consulting and finance at Dartmouth. So a lot of like career-wise, a lot of students tend to go into those fields just because of a lot of resources, which totally makes sense, and they're very profitable. Like we're just good at consulting and finance, but then it really dissuades a lot of other students from pursuing alternative careers, which is very detrimental, I think, to like the student body's diversity in terms of like pursuing passions. The next thing is very niche. This is for modified majors, and this is like a kind of build your own major thing that Dartmouth offers, which is awesome. Like I'm a modified major at Dartmouth of econ and film, but I've just heard friends who have had like really arbitrary approvals or disapprovals of their majors. So I don't know what criteria are like aligned for students to get that approved, but there's been definitely like friends who have who've submitted the same proposal and one got it approved and the other one didn't. And I just like, why? I don't know. The next thing is the D plan, which I like love slash hate. I think it's really great, offers a lot of opportunities, but it also keeps your friends apart. The D plan is our trimester like quarter system where we have a term for each season and you can be on campus taking classes, you can be off campus working or doing something else, or you could be abroad or doing the exchange. And so people, you know, they try to line up their D plans with their friends, but honestly just they do it given what programs are offered when, and because of that you might not see some friends for like a full year if you're just not on campus at the same times. The next thing is that there's a lot of institutionalized exclusion at Dartmouth, mostly socially, unfortunately, and this is gonna be a problem anywhere, but anywhere with like semi-exclusive social groups, things like Greek houses or different student groups that you have to apply or like audition for. If you're in, you're in, and if you're not, you're just really not. So it's a bummer when people aren't and they want to be. I think a lot of people choose to not engage in them like for their own reasons. And that's totally fine, but when people like would love a new social group and like can't break in because of like lack of merit or like some arbitrary reason, it really sucks. Sometimes it doesn't, and sometimes it's like totally not a big deal, but for some people it really negatively affects their Dartmouth experience. I don't think that's right. But anyways, so that was like a lot of negativity. I don't like being super negative, so I'm gonna go into the positives, and thankfully I have a lot more positives than negatives about Dartmouth. I think one thing that people always say when it's like, what's your favorite thing about Dartmouth? They're always gonna say the people, and that's boring, so I don't want to say that, but it is very true. There are just some phenomenal people at Dartmouth. The first like real thing is that it is beautiful at Dartmouth. Like the location it's in, Hanover, New Hampshire, yes it's a trek, but it is like breathtakingly beautiful in every season, and in every season there's something different to do. So in winter you can do snow sports, there's ice skating on Occam Pond, very affordable. In the fall there's apple picking and hikes, in the summer also hikes, canoeing with Ledyard on the river, and like so many other activities. Additionally, the stars at night are amazing. You're in the middle of nowhere, so definitely go stargazing once when you're at Dartmouth. The next thing is the quarter system. The quarter system gives people a lot of freedom. I mentioned that the D plan can rip you apart from your friends, but it gives you so much flexibility in doing a lot of different programs that you want to do and finishing your degree. So you can study abroad, you could do an exchange program, you can intern somewhere instead of being on campus and still graduate on time, which is crazy. I took an entire year off. I took my entire junior year off with a gap year, and I'm still walking at graduation with my class, and then I just have one extra term after that in the fall to finish. Additionally, with the quarter system, you have the ability to take a lot of different classes and that might not be within your major and still graduate on time with your degree. So liberal arts is awesome. You have a lot of distributive requirements that you need to do, which can be a hassle, but can also really open your eyes to other departments that you may have never experienced. So there's a lot of students who are just very well-rounded in their breadth of knowledge. Along with that, there are some awesome professors at Dartmouth. I mentioned how I was upset that some didn't get tenured, but that's because I love them so much. And there's a lot of opportunities to really get to know your professors at Dartmouth. There's a program that lets you take your professor out to lunch for free in town, which is really nice, and I've done that before. And professors, since there's just fewer students, you just have a lot more access, like a lot of one-on-one time with professors. Office hours and just scheduled meetings are just, there's just a culture of getting to know your professors really well. I know I complain a lot about winter, but winter also forges really strong bonds with the people you're around because you're kind of stuck in the snow with a select group of people, so you get to know people really well. Additionally, just being remote, like away from a city, all of life is focused and centralized on campus. So people are really active, like in the community, and you just have a lot of opportunities to get to know people. And along with those lines, because we're not really in the city life, like socialization, the going out scene is all like very Dartmouth. It's like very quirky. Dartmouth is a quirky school, a lot of weird traditions, starting from trips to just like our lingo. The way we speak is very unique to just us. Things like flair and how wacky people get dressed up to go out. There's no judgment. You can do whatever you want, wear whatever you want. And I think that's so fun and so unique to a school that's not in a city. Along with going out, Dartmouth Pong is so fun and you will not find it anywhere else. Additionally, I think the going out scene at Dartmouth is really inclusive compared to other schools in that on a regular on night or a regular on hours, you can walk into any frat that's open and there's no guest list. There's no sense of like you can or cannot be here. Like when things get over capacity, then it starts being more selective of like, okay, if you know someone in the frat, then you can come in because technically they're not supposed to let people in, but they'll let their friends in. At other schools, there's like a guest list and like invites and that sort of thing. And there's a select number of events that are like invite only, but very few compared to like the regular on night. And I think it's actually really impressive that you can just go wherever you want at Dartmouth. It's a different thing when it comes to who's comfortable in which spaces. That totally depends on who you're close to and the kind of vibe that you're looking for. But like logistically, you're allowed anywhere. Like no one can really say no to you. Kind of jumping off the things that I was complaining about, how it might seem like there's a lot of people who are really ignorant, really privileged, and just like general like lack of woke at Dartmouth. But there's actually a lot of really interesting, very woke, very well-informed people, and though that may not seem to be like the dominant culture all the time, especially at old, predominantly white, old money Ivies, which is like all of them, there are a lot of really interesting, socially aware people, and I wish that that was felt like more of the predominant thing. I think there's more people like that than it might seem like initially. Oh, and along with that, I am constantly shocked by the amount of talent there is at Dartmouth, whether it's in the arts, singing, acapella, dance, visual art, just in terms of what people do in terms of with their research and the jobs that they've done, the internships they've done. There are incredibly talented, smart, accomplished people, and you probably wouldn't know that about them because Dartmouth is a really humble place, in my opinion. Like there's a lot of people who do ridiculously cool things, and you wouldn't really know that until you get to know them. Of course, some people will brag about their BAME internship, but at this point, no one really cares. But there's some people who are just like phenomenally talented. In terms of after college, I think the alumni network is something that does not get enough credit, where it can seem really hard and distant while you're at school, but once you graduate, you really see how strong that alumni network is. My older sister literally got an amazing job through a friend at Dartmouth, and I think there's just like a lot of camaraderie forged through Dartmouth and a lot of trust Dartmouth students have for each other, and that makes a huge difference in the adult world looking for jobs. However, on campus, if you're looking for opportunities to do independent projects, there's a lot of pockets of money that people don't really talk about, but I think they're trying to make it more accessible, but if you just look up like funds or like scholarships or whatever at Dartmouth, there's a bunch and you can apply to them for a number of different things depending on like what project you're trying to do. There's also this thing called the self fund offered by the CPD or the Center for Professional Development that literally is like, if you're doing an alternative career or internship that doesn't pay that much, they'll literally pay for you to be able to take a chance and do that internship. Along with other opportunities, the study abroad programs at Dartmouth are amazing for language and other departments. It's very common for students to study abroad at least once, and I highly recommend it. My third to last thing is just that people have kind of an obligation to be friendly because it's such a small community that if you smile at someone, they probably will smile back. Even if they don't, it's their fault. But I feel like I go anywhere as a senior and I have a friendly face that I can say hi to. Like literally any space on campus, I will probably see someone I know that I could chat with or just say hello to. And I think that's really like the merit of a small school as well. I guess that was my second to last thing. My real last thing is just that there's something for everyone at Dartmouth. No matter the type of person you are or your interest or whatever, there are going to be people like you. It just might take more work to find those people. And it also really requires you to foster a lot of patience socially with people who probably are really different from you in your ways of thinking, in your value systems. And this can be really frustrating, but I think it also has been one of the most valuable lessons I've learned in college, that I can't judge people who are different than me, and I need to give people a chance, because when I do, I can always find something that I really love and respect about them. And it's really just helps open up a lot of doors and opportunities and friendships. It takes risk. It takes you stepping out and saying that I want this out of my college career, I'm gonna go for it, but I swear you will find someone or something that is able to help you out and just join you along the way. And I just want to close with like this musing, this statement, because I think a predominant thing, as I mentioned, a lot of things I don't like about Dartmouth is that there can kind of be like an overall sense of pessimism about making changes or about just like your social standing at Dartmouth, belonging at Dartmouth, and that sort of thing. But I really do wonder what Dartmouth would look like if every student who attended just behaved as if they belonged and really internalized the fact that they are chosen to be there for a reason and that they have something to gain. There's so many opportunities at Dartmouth that I think it's hard to be thankful for in the moment, especially with things like stress in school and like social pressure. But I think a lot of alums that I've spoken to express a lot of gratitude for after the fact. I would love to see a Dartmouth where everyone there owned the space and felt like they belonged and refused to be belittled or shut down by anybody. I know that's kind of a rant. This has been a very long video, but I hope you enjoyed and learned something about Dartmouth. Yeah, if you have any questions about Dartmouth or just want to chat, feel free to DM me. I am always happy to respond. Sometimes it takes me a little longer, especially when I'm busy with school, but DMs and comments on videos, I respond to pretty much any comment if you have a question. So thank you guys so much for watching. Again, congrats to all of the class of 23, oh my gosh, that's crazy, who's gotten in. Love you guys, you deserve it, and I trust that you will make a very good decision on where to spend the rest of your 4 years, and I just want you to know that whether you got into Dartmouth, or maybe you didn't get into a school that you really wanted to go to, wherever you go, a lot of these same things apply, where you will find something for yourself there, and you will be able to have an amazing experience wherever you go. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this. Love you, Jesus loves you, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.